Hello, my name is Gabija, and today I'll be discussing the differences between forward and reverse proxy servers. But before I do that, let's look at each type separately to make sure we know what they are to begin with. So, what is a forward proxy? Simply put, instead of direct communication between your computer and the web server, a middleman appears. In this case, that's a forward proxy. Then, the request goes through the proxy server before being sent to the web server. The most common types of forward proxies are residential proxies and data center proxies. You can learn more about them in one of our other videos. So, what are forward proxies used for? There are many reasons for single users or businesses to use forward proxy servers. Firstly, forward proxy servers could come in handy when accessing geo-restricted content. Let's say when users browse the internet, they usually see specific content based on their geolocation. So when they use a forward proxy, users can access content intended for other countries. This can be especially useful for companies that provide ad verification services. With the forward proxy, companies can monitor ads regardless of their geolocation. Secondly, a forward proxy server acts as an additional safety layer that hides the web server's real IP address by using one of its own. This is the exact reason why using forward proxy servers ensures higher level of anonymity and security. And the third reason to use a forward proxy is public web scraping. Companies usually gather data with forward proxies to improve their marketing, pricing, and other business strategies. They can also be used to control and monitor internet usage, create and manage social media accounts, and much, much more. All right, so let's move on to answering what a reverse proxy is. A reverse proxy server is implemented in front of a web server and directs client requests to the specific backend server. These proxies ensure that users would not communicate directly with an origin server and, in this way, provide anonymity to the web server. A reverse proxy is the perfect fit for websites that have numerous daily visitors as they help increase web servers' security, performance, and help prevent overloading. Aside from the increased security and performance of web servers, reverse proxies can also be used in more use cases as well. Firstly, websites with many daily users usually cannot handle all the traffic with a single origin server. Therefore, websites allocate their users' traffic among a cluster of different backend servers. These servers then manage client requests for the same website. Additionally, a reverse proxy can help any single server avoid overloading because all of the site's traffic has to go through a reverse proxy. Only then can the traffic access a specific backend server. Secondly, if a website uses a reverse proxy, its server's address is hidden and hackers can only access the proxy's IP address. This poses a challenge for hackers and malicious entities. For example, it's much harder to make a DDoS attack as a website that uses a reverse proxy because when a website uses reverse proxies, hackers will only be able to attack the proxies, which will work as an additional security layer. Another use case for a reverse proxy would be caching. Caching allows websites to efficiently reuse previously obtained data. A reverse proxy server can be used to cache the website's content and increase the website's performance. And the final use case in our list is SSL encryption. Encrypting and decrypting SSL communications for each use case can be ineffective for an origin server, especially if a website has a lot of daily traffic. A reverse proxy can do this job by encrypting and decrypting all of the requests. So as you can tell, a reverse proxy is essentially for every website that has to deal with numerous visitors every day. All right, so let's move on to the main topic of this video, the difference between forward and reverse proxy. So the most noticeable difference between reverse and forward proxy is that the users use a forward proxy to connect to a web server. In contrast, a reverse proxy is deployed on the web server side. So simply put, these proxy servers are on the contrary sides of the connection. Forward proxies ensure that websites never communicate directly with a user, whereas reverse proxies ensure that users would not communicate directly with a backend server. And finally, the main difference between these two types of proxies lies in their purpose. Regular users utilize forward proxies for privacy reasons, such as accessing geo-restricted content, public web scraping, and others. While web servers use a reverse proxy to avoid overloading, add additional safety layers from hackers and malicious entities, caching, and for SSL encryption. But can a forward proxy act as a reverse proxy? Well, simply put, no. A forward proxy server cannot act as a reverse proxy server. Even if these concepts may sound similar, they're utilized for entirely different purposes. A proxy by itself is not only an IP address, Proxies consist of IP addresses and dedicated software that allows them to operate in an intended manner. As forward and reverse proxies are used for different tasks, they each have different software to perform smoothly. This is the reason why you cannot use forward proxies as reverse proxies. Okay, so I hope that this video has helped you understand the difference between a forward proxy and a reverse proxy, and which proxy type suits your needs the best. So thank you for watching. If you have any questions about proxies or would like to find out more about any specific topic, contact us at hello@oxylabs.io or simply write a comment down below and we'll make sure to answer you. Also, if you like this content, please leave a like or share it on your social media, and I'll see you in other videos. Goodbye.